गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ पंकज रामावत। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट लीगल इश्यू इन मेंटल हेल्थ नर्सिंग। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, लीगल इश्यू इन मेंटल हेल्थ मीन्स इम्प्लीकेशन ऑफ लॉ फॉर द मेंटल हेल्थ। नाउ वी स्टार्ट इंट्रोडक्शन। इंडियन मेंटल हेल्थ एक्ट वॉज ड्राफ्टेड बाई द पार्लियामेंट इन 1987, बट इट केम इन टू इफेक्ट इन ऑल द स्टेट एंड यूनियन टेरेटरीज ऑफ इंडिया इन अप्रैल 1993। This act replaces the Indian Lunacy Act 1912. Why we need this? First, to change the attitude of the society towards the mentally ill, and considerably realized that no stigma should be attached to such illness. Then, every mentally ill individual has the right to be treated like other sick people. Then, modify the act according to the rapid advancement of medical science and the understanding. Objective of Mental Health Act: first, to regulate the power of government for establishing, licensing and controlling psychiatric hospital or nursing homes. Then, to provide legal aid mentally ill person at state expenses in certain cases. Then protect citizen from being detained in psychiatric hospital or nursing homes without sufficient cases. Then central and state authorities for mental health services to regulate maintenance charges of psychiatric hospital or nursing homes. Act. The act is divided into 10 chapters and consisting of 98 sections. Then we start chapter first. Some terminology we use like psychiatric hospital or nursing homes means a hospital, nursing homes established or maintained by the government or any other person for the case of mentally ill person. Then mentally ill person means a person who is in need of treatment by reason of any mental disorder other than mental retardation. Psychiatrist means a medical practitioner possessing postgraduate degree or diploma in psychiatry recognized by the MCI, Medical Council of India. Then reception order means an order made under the provision of this act for the admission and detention of mentally ill person in psychiatric hospital or nursing homes. The outdated definition are changed based on current knowledge. The old term, new term. First, we discuss lunatic means mentally ill person. Then lunatic asylum, psychiatric hospital. Then criminal lunatic means mentally ill prisoner. Now the chapter second, it deal with establishment of central and state authorities for regulation and coordination of mental health services. Chapter third, it provide guideline for establishment and maintenance of psychiatric hospital or nursing homes. Chapter fourth, it deal with procedure for admission and detention in psychiatric hospital. Now we discuss admission and discharge. First of all, types of admission. Admission on voluntary basis, then admission under authority, then admission under special circumstances. Admission under authority divided into three parts. First, reception on application, section 20. Then reception on production before magistrate, section 23. Then reception after, section 26, admission and detention of mentally ill. First, discuss admission on voluntary basis. Request by a major or guardian of the minor for admission to medical officer, then medical officer make inquiry within 24 hours. If the medical officer is satisfied for admission, then voluntary admission is made. Admission under special circumstances or involuntary. Patient is unwilling or unable to make a request for admission. A relative or friend make an application to the medical officer on behalf of the patient. Then medical officer make inquiry within 24 hours. Then if the medical officer is satisfied for admission, involuntary admission is made. Admission under authority or order. Mentally ill person can be admitted to psychiatric nursing hospital by court of law or an approved authority. The authority can pass an order for reception and detention mainly under four different categories. First, reception order on application, reception order on production of a mentally ill before magistrate, reception order after inquest, admission and detention of a mentally ill prisoner. Now, reception order on application. Only a relative not other than husband, wife, guardian or a friend can make out an application for admission of client. Then two official certificate needed. Then being a minor, on one has not seen the mentally ill patient in last 14 days can make such application. Then with the application, a medical officer can extend inpatient treatment to more than 6 months. Reception order on production of mentally ill person before a magistrate. Mentally ill patient exhibit violent behavior detained by police, then produced in the court within 24 hours of detention. Application is supported by two medical certificate, then magistrate issue reception order. Reception order after inquest. First, inquest of mentally ill patient by district court. Then the interest of such person, district court or direct for admission. Then admission is made. Admission under reception order. First, petition, then examination, then determination, then medical administrator. Now, medical administrator release or hospitalize. If hospitalized, then first emergency to control on immediate threat to self or others, then short term for diagnosis and short term therapy, then long term and treatment and determined ready for discharge. Chapter 5. Discharge procedure to be followed for a mental hospital under different circumstances. Discharge procedure. First, voluntary discharge under Section 18. Second, discharge under special admission Section 19. Discharge in respect of admission due to an order of an authority in all five types. First, discharge of a patient admitted on voluntary basis. In medical officer in charge of psychiatric hospital or nursing home on recommendation from two medical practitioner, preferably a psychiatrist, can issue direction for discharge of the patient. Discharge of patient under special circumstances. First, relative or a friend may be make an application to the medical officer for care and custody of the patient. Then relative are required to furnish a bond with or without surety. Then along with an undertaking that the mentally ill person shall be prevented from causing injury to self or others. Discharge of a patient admitted on reception order. First, application, then a certificate from the medical officer in charge of psychiatric hospital or nursing home. A magistrate issue an order if patient is fit for discharge. Discharge of a patient admitted by police. If police detain the mentally ill individual in hospital, he may be discharged after the family member agree in writing to take proper care that he is fit to be discharged. Then, discharge of mentally ill prisoner. First, hospital authorities have to report every 6 months about the person's state of mind to the authority which had ordered detention. Then, as soon the client is fit to stand in trial, they have to inform about the same to the authority concerned. Then person then hand over to the prison officer for further legal action. Leave of absence, section 45. It means patient is given time limit permission to visit family member. On application by a relative or other to medical officer in charge and a bond duly signed stating that the patient will taken proper care of and prevented from injuring self or others for a period of maximum 6 days. Chapter 6 consists of legal customary action towards the property possessed by mentally ill person. Under section 54, a guardian may be appointed by court of law on behalf of an alleged mentally ill person incapable of looking after self and property. Under section 97 of the Act, when a mentally ill person is not represented by a legal practitioner in any proceeding before a district court or magistrate, and such a patient does not have sufficient means to engage a legal practitioner, then district court. Chapter 7 deal with way and means to meet the loss of maintenance of mentally ill person detained in psychiatric hospital. Under section 78, when a mentally ill patient is detained as an inpatient and does not have property to bear the cost of treatment, in such cases these expenses shall be borne by the government of states. Chapter 8 contain the novel explicit provision for protection of human rights of mentally ill patient. Section 81 provides that first, no letter or communication sent by or to a mentally ill person shall be interrupted, detained or destroyed. Second, no mentally ill person shall be subjected during treatment to any indignity, physically or mentally, or cruelty. Third, no mentally ill person under treatment shall be used to purpose of research unless, first, such research is of direct benefit to him, second, a consent has been obtained in writing from person in voluntary admission or from the guardian relative if admission was involuntary. Chapter 9 deal with procedure to be followed for the establishment and maintenance of psychiatric hospital and penalties which can be relatively severe and explicit for containing them. Article 6 of the Mental Health Act prohibit the running of a home without license. Article 11 say the licensing authority can revoke the license if the maintenance of the manor detrimental to the moral, mental or physical well-being ऑफ द पेशेंट। चैप्टर 10 इट डील विद क्लैरिफिकेशन पर्टेंटिंग टू सर्टेन प्रोसीजर टू बी फॉलोड द मेडिकल ऑफिसर इन चार्ज ऑफ द साइकेट्रिक हॉस्पिटल और नर्सिंग होम्स। नाउ वी डिस्कस मेंटल हेल्थ केयर बिल 2013। इन दिस मेंटल हेल्थ केयर बिल 2013 वाज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इन राज्यसभा ऑन अगस्त 19, 2013। द बिल एबोलिस्ड द मेंटल हेल्थ एक्ट 1987। इट हैव 16 चैप्टर्स। द चैप्टर्स आर चैप्टर फर्स्ट प्रीलिमिनरी इंफॉर्मेशन ऑन डेफिनेशन शॉर्ट टाइटल्स एक्सटेंट एंड कमासमेंट। चैप्टर टू मेंटल इलनेस एंड कैपेसिटी टू मेक मेंटल हेल्थ केयर ट्रीटमेंट डिसीजन। चैप्टर थ्री एडवांस डायरेक्टिव। चैप्टर फोर नॉमिनेटिव रिप्रेजेंटेटिव। चैप्टर फाइव राइट ऑफ पर्सन विद मेंटल इलनेस। चैप्टर सिक्स ड्यूटीज ऑफ अप्रोप्रिएट गवर्नमेंट। चैप्टर सेवन सेंट्रल मेंटल अथॉरिटीज। चैप्टर एट स्टेट मेंटल हेल्थ अथॉरिटी। चैप्टर नाइन फाइनेंस अकाउंट एंड ऑडिट। टेन मेंटल हेल्थ एस्टेब्लिशमेंट। इलेवन मेंटल हेल्थ रिव्यू कमीशन। चैप्टर 12 एडमिशन ट्रीटमेंट एंड डिस्चार्ज। चैप्टर 13 रिस्पॉन्सिबल ऑफ अदर एजेंसी। चैप्टर 14 रेस्ट्रिक्शन ऑफ डिस्चार्ज फंक्शनल बाय प्रोफेशनल नॉट कवर्ड बाय प्रोफेशन। चैप्टर 15 ऑफेंस एंड पेनल्टीज। चैप्टर 16 इसिलेनियस। नर्स इम्प्लीकेशन फॉर प्रोटेक्टिंग पेशेंट राइट। नर्स शुड गाइड द पेशेंट रिलेटिव टू देयर राइट्स एंड प्रोटेक्ट द पेशेंट फ्रॉम मिसट्रीटमेंट। नर्स शुड बी अवेयर ऑफ द राइट्स इन द फर्स्ट प्लेस। नर्सिंग केयर प्लान शुड इंक्लूड राइट्स ऑफ द पेशेंट एंड इट शुड बी डिस्कस्ड बाय द मेंटल हेल्थ टीम। थैंक यू स्टूडेंट्स।